Okay, so good morning everyone. My name is Dr. Ashok Arvind Jadhav. Today we are going to discuss pseudophores. Basically, in the last lecture we have seen two frame of references. One is inertial and another is non-inertial, or we can say accelerating or non-accelerating frame of reference. So we are having one frame. In the frame, if your observer or the frame is basically accelerating with respect to time, or if you consider that the velocity of the frame is changing with respect to time, then we can say that frame is a accelerating frame or non-inertial frame of reference. On the other hand, we have seen that if frame is a fixed, if frame does not move with respect to time, or if frame is moving with some constant velocity, then we can say it's a inertial frame of reference or non-accelerating frame of reference. So we have discussed that we are having two frame of references. One is inertial and another is non-inertial. In this case, we have observed that if you look at the Newton's laws of motion, then all the Newton's laws of motion are applicable in the inertial frame of references. On the other hand, if you wanted to apply Newton's laws of motion in non-inertial frame of reference, in that case, we have to consider one imaginary force which is observed by the observer during the some centrifugal motion or some curve path. So at that time, an imaginary force was there, and that force is known as a pseudo force. We have seen an example that some student is, let us consider, sitting in the car, and when car is taking turn over a curve path, at that time he feels that he is basically throwing outward. So why it's happening? This is basically due to the acceleration of frame. So that we have seen in the last lecture. Now we are going to discuss pseudo force in details in this lecture. So let us consider we are having two frame of references. Let us consider one frame S frame and another frame S prime frame. So here I have shown two frame of references, or basically we can consider XYZ axis, it's a one frame, and X prime, Y prime, Z prime as another X frame of reference. So S frame and S prime frame, these are two frames we are having. Now we are going to consider S prime frame is accelerating frame moving with some acceleration A0 with respect to S frame. So what we are going to consider, let us consider example like Rishikesh is standing on the bus stand, and some let us consider Rohit is in a car, and car is accelerating with some acceleration A0. So for car, we can consider some X prime, Y prime, Z prime as a coordinate system, and for Rishikesh, who is standing on the bus stand, we can consider X, Y, Z as a frame of reference. So we are having two frame of references, one X, Y, Z, which is a static frame of reference, which does not move, and Rohit, who is sitting in the car, who is sitting in the bus, there we are having X prime, Y prime, and Z prime as a frame of reference. So when you consider S prime frame of reference, then as it is moving with some acceleration A0, then we can say S prime frame is a non-inertial frame of reference, as it is a accelerating with A0 acceleration. And S frame is inertial frame where Rishikesh is standing. So we can say it is a static frame, or we can say as Earth is rotating with some constant velocity, so it is a frame which is moving with some constant velocity or static pace. So we are having two frame of references, S and S prime. Now what we are going to consider, consider a particle placed in a S prime frame. And now we are going to consider how it looks from S frame and S prime frame. And it is moving basically. So we will consider some P point which is in a S prime frame. So what we are going to consider, we are having a Rohit is sitting in the bus. So in the bus we are having some, let us consider one butterfly, and that butterfly is there and it is also moving. Now we are going to analyze both the things. What we are going to analyze? We are going to analyze a butterfly from a moving bus as well as from the bus stand. What we are going to analyze? We are going to analyze a butterfly which is moving in the bus from two frame of references. First is S prime frame and another is S prime. म्हणजेच काय, ऋषिकेश जो बस स्टँड वर बसलेला आहे तो त्या बसमध्ये फिरणारं फुलपाखरू जे आहे ते फुलपाखरू पाहणार आहे आणि रोहित जो त्या बसमध्ये बसलेला आहे तोही तेच फुलपाखरू पाहणार. दोघही त्या फुलपाखराला अनालाइज करणार आहे, दोघही त्या फुलपाखरूची मोशन कशी असेल हे पाहायचा प्रयत्न करणार. ओके, सो होप यू गॉट व्हॉट आय मीन बाय एस प्राइम फ्रेम अँड एस प्रेम. कळालं सर्वांना एस प्राइम फ्रेम आणि एस प्रेम काय आहे ते? Yes or no?
Sir.
Okay.
Yes.
Now let us consider a velocity of that particle from S frame. So if I consider velocity observed by observer in S frame is a V prime or V bar basically. So what I mean by this? I mean by this, Rishikesh, which is standing on the bus stand, he observed that butterfly is moving with velocity v. ओके, कळालं का? मग जो ऋषिकेश बस स्टँडला उभा होता तो ऋषिकेश काय म्हणेल की ते फुलपाखरू जे काही बस मध्ये आहे ते v या वेलॉसिटीने पुढे जात. अँड ऑब्झर्वर हु इज इन अ एस प्राइम फ्रेम ऑब्झर्व दॅट द वेलॉसिटी ऑफ दॅट बटरफ्लाय इज v प्राइम. मग रोहित जो की त्या बस मध्ये बसलेला आहे तो जर त्या फुलपाखराला पाहत असेल तर तो काय म्हणेल की v प्राइम या वेलॉसिटीने ते फुलपाखरू पुढे झालं. बरोबर आहे का? मग आता मला सांगा बरं, व्ही आणि व्ही प्राईम दोन्ही व्हॅल्यू सेम असणार आहेत का डिफरंट असणार?
डिफरंट.
ऋषिकेश सेम डिफरंट. ओके,
सेम.
हा बोला.
सेम सेम
सेम.
नाही, सेम नसणार दोन्ही व्हॅल्यू. का? कारण ऋषिकेश जेव्हा त्या फुलपाखराला पाहतोय ना, जेव्हा तो त्या बस स्टँड वर उभा आहे आणि त्या फुलपाखराला पाहतोय, तर त्या केसमध्ये त्या फुलपाखराची वेलॉसिटी वेगळी असणार आहे. का वेगळी असणार आहे? बिकॉज देर इज अ वेलॉसिटी ऑर बेसिकली देर इज ऍक्सलरेशन ऑफ दॅट बस विच इज अ मुव्हिंग. त्या बसची वेलॉसिटी आणि त्या फुलपाखराची वेलॉसिटी या दोघांचं कॉम्बिनेशन म्हणून वी असणार आहे. बरोबर आहे का? बस मूव्ह होते, बरोबर ना? मग तुम्हाला फ्रेम ऑफ रेफरन्स जे म्हणाल ना की कोणत्या फ्रेम मधून आपण ती वस्तू पाहतोय ते महत्वाचं असत. ओनली यू कॅन अप्लाय न्यूटन्स लॉज ऑफ मोशन इन अ इनर्शियल फ्रेम ऑफ रेफरन्स. इफ यू वॉन्टेड टू अप्लाय न्यूटन्स लॉज ऑफ मोशन इन नॉन इनर्शियल फ्रेम ऑफ रेफरन्स देन वी हॅव टू अप्लाय सुडो फोर्स. वी विल डिस्कस हाउ द सुडो फोर्स विल केम इन द पिक्चर. सो वी हॅव सेड दॅट इफ एन ऑब्झर्वर हु इज सिटिंग ऑन द बस स्टँड ही ऑब्झर्व दॅट द वेलॉसिटी ऑफ बटरफ्लाय इज वी अँड ऑब्झर्वर लाईक अ रोहित हु इज इन अ बस he observed that the velocity of butterfly is a v prime. Okay, now let us consider a law of addition of velocities. Again here we have to consider basically a vector summation. So if you look at the diagram, so in this diagram we are having this u as initial velocity, one can say that the particle is moving. So if you look at the p particle here, then its velocity from S prime frame is a V prime and velocity of that same particle P from S frame is V. So using that I can write down V prime is equals to V minus U. So V prime is what? V prime is a velocity from S prime frame, V is a velocity from this S frame and U is basically a velocity of that car or that bus. So what is this? I told you that when Rishikesh is looking at that butterfly, at that time he will observe that this velocity is combination of two different things. What are two different things? First, velocity of S prime means velocity of bus plus velocity of that particle, velocity of that butterfly. Am I correct? Pa jeva Rishikesh tya butterfly la pahnar ahe tyavelas tyala kay disnar ahe, tar te butterfly jeva move hotoy त्यावेळेला त्याला बसची जी वेलॉसिटी असेल ती वेलॉसिटी प्लस त्या बटरफ्लायची वेलॉसिटी दॅट विल बी व्ही. बरोबर ना? सो बघा इथे व्ही इज इक्वल्स टू काय असेल मग व्ही प्राईम प्लस यू असणार आहे. सो वी कॅन राईट डाऊन व्ही प्राईम इज इक्वल्स टू व्ही मायनस यू. एम आय करेक्ट? read out regarding this. Key statement is mentioned here using the law of addition of velocities. V prime is equals to V minus U. Here you read the kaala by statement difference.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now let us consider that it changes time as a frame is accelerating. Now, as we have seen that the as we have discussed that burst is basically accelerating. That S prime frame is accelerating with acceleration a. Barabar na a zero we have mentioned that. So if you look at the u, then u is what velocity of burst. And if I take a du by dt of that velocity, then what I will get? I will get acceleration of a burst. Am I correct? But u is a velocity of burst, and as the burst is accelerating with respect to time, so what I will observe? Du by dt change in the velocity with respect to time will be basically acceleration of burst. Am I correct? Okay. So let us differentiate equation. This equation v prime is equals to u by v by v minus u. So d v prime by dt is equals to dv by dt minus du by dt. And I told you that du by dt is what? It's a acceleration of a burst. So I can write down du by dt as a a zero. So it simply gives dv prime by dt as a acceleration of a prime frame is equals to, sorry, acceleration of not a prime frame, acceleration of that butterfly is a prime, which is equals to a minus a zero, where a is what? And a zero is ka and a prime ka hai sanga bara tha. V manje ka hai, v prime manje ka hai, velocity of butterfly with respect to Rohit. V is the velocity of butterfly with respect to Rishikesh, and u is a velocity of S prime frame with respect to S frame. Means basically a velocity of bus with respect to bus stand. Bus stand is stationary, so we can observe. Basically, we can measure what will be the velocity of bus. So according to that, I can determine what is A prime, what is A, and what is A. A prime is a acceleration of butterfly with respect to Rohit. Rohit will observe that A prime is a acceleration of that butterfly. Am I correct? Did you get it?
Sir.
हाँ बोला.
सर ते acceleration of A bar है ना, तर ते जो बस मध्ये बसलेला आहे त्याच्या रिस्पेक्ट मध्ये ना.
ए बार जो आहे, समजतो ना, ए बार जो आहे ना तो काय असणार आहे, तर त्या बटरफ्लायची बटरफ्लायचं ऍक्सलरेशन वेन रोहित इज लुकिंग ऍट दॅट बटरफ्लाय. बरोबर आहे का? बटरफ्लायची वेलॉसिटी आपल्याला माहिती व्ही आहे, बरोबर ना? आणि ती वेलॉसिटी कोण पाहत आहे? ही व्ही वेलॉसिटी कोण पाहणार आहे? तो रोहित पाहणार आहे. व्ही ही वेलॉसिटी रोहित पाहणार आहे. व्ही प्राईम ही वेलॉसिटी, सॉरी, व्ही प्राईम ही वेलॉसिटी रोहित पाहणार, v ही वेलॉसिटी ऋषिकेश पाहणार, आणि u म्हणजे काय? वेलॉसिटी ऑफ बस. बरोबर आहे का? मग त्याच जर आपण डिफरेन्शिएशन घेतलं तर मला काय मिळतंय? a प्राइम. a प्राइम मीन्स व्हॉट? ऍक्सलरेशन ऑफ बटरफ्लाय विच इज ऑब्झर्व बाय द रोहित. a बार इज अ ऍक्सलरेशन ऑफ बटरफ्लाय विच इज ऑब्झर्व बाय ऋषिकेश, अँड a झिरो इज अ acceleration of bus. Did you get it? हे तीन जे टर्म्स आहेत, a प्राइम, a आणि a झिरो, काय आहेत? काय आहे सर्वांना?
यस सर.
यस सर.
प्रणव काय आलं का?
सर म्हणजे a प्राइम हा नॉन इनर्शियल फ्रेमच्या रेफरन्स मध्ये ना.
हो, a प्राइम म्हणजे काय? बस. आणि बस ही कोणती आहे? s प्राइम फ्रेम आहे. आणि s प्राइम फ्रेम म्हणजे नॉन इनर्शियल फ्रेम ऑफ रेफरन्स. a म्हणजे काय? a इज फ्रॉम इनर्शियल फ्रेम ऑफ रेफरन्स. And A0 is a basically acceleration of non-inertial frame with respect to inertial frame. S prime frame with respect to S prime. So, let us move ahead. Now, let us multiply this last equation by M. That is the mass of that butterfly. If I try to determine it, then what I will get? m a prime is equals to m a minus m a 0. So I will get f prime bar is equals to f bar minus f 0 bar. Now here f is what? F prime bar is what? F prime bar is a total force which is equals to force observed by observer who is in S frame minus fictitious force. Now look at here. F prime is a force observed, basically total force observed in S prime frame. F is a force observed from S frame, and F0 is coming due to the fictitious force, which is basically an imaginary force. So we are having F prime is equals to F minus F0.
Yes, sir.
Okay. F prime, I have written here. It turned down here. So the force F bar is equals to MA bar is observed in initial frame, that is S frame. F prime is equals to MA prime is a total force acting on the particle as observed by the observer in S prime is a non-initial frame. And F0 is a fictitious force which does not exist, but it simply represents the effect of accelerating frame. Basically, it is not observed from S frame, but it can be come in the picture due to the motion or acceleration of that S prime frame. So it is in an opposite direction to the force F bar observed in initial frame operation, because it has minus sign. Okay? Kalakai?
Sir.
Okay. Now let us give an example. We have seen example, like I have told you, if someone is sitting in the car, then if you look at this driver and the back seater who is there. Now why that back seater only feel that force and driver doesn't feel it? Cover asa pahayla mishitri, jo to driver ahe, to driver pa, jeva turn ghenar hai na, to automatically tya bajula jhuklay, barabar tya bajula jhala turn ghyaycha. Barabar hai ka? So he is basically trying to neglect that force or minimize that force. But on the other hand, karan kya driver la maithi ki to vadan ghenar hai, त्यामुळे तो त्या बाजूला झुकून घेतो ऑलरेडी. मग त्यामुळे तो पलीकडे फेकला जाणार ना, तो पलीकडे फेकला जातो. ऑन द अदर हँड हू इज ऍट द बॅक सीट, ही विल बेसिकली थ्रोइंग इन द बेसिकली अपोजिट डायरेक्शन ऑफ द. सो एक्झाम्पल, फर्स्ट पॅसेंजर सिटिंग इन अ बस. यू माइट हॅव हर्ड दॅट इफ देर इज वन ड्रायव्हर अँड हू इज बेसिकली ड्रायव्हिंग दॅट बस विथ द स्पीड ऑफ लेट अस कन्सिडर 60-80 kilometer per hour, and suddenly some animal came in the road. Then what he will do? If that animal come in the road, then what he will do? He applies the brake. Now he knows that there is one animal who is coming in the road and he can apply the brake. So at that time he is applying the brake, so he can stop himself by feeling that forward jerk. But the passengers who are at the back side of the seats, they don't know whether there is one animal or something is there, but they feel that there is someone who is pushing their back to the forward. Barabar hai ka? Jo bus madhe basle passenger ahet tanna asa vatte ki bus driver jab bus cha brake marla, bus cha brake dabla, tar te pude fekle jatat. Tumhi asa anubhav ghetlay ka? अनुभव घेतलाय का की तुम्ही बसमध्ये बसलेला आहात, बस ड्रायव्हरने ब्रेक मारले, तुम्ही पुढे गेलात, असं अनुभव घेतलाय का कधी?
यस सर.
नाउ व्हाई इट्स हॅपनिंग, व्हाई इट्स हॅपनिंग?
बिकॉज वी आर इन मोशन अँड इट बस सडनली स्टॉप्स.
दिस मीन्स दॅट बेसिकली वी आर ट्राइंग टू चेंज एस प्राइम फ्रेम टू एस फ्रेम. बरोबर आहे ना? S prime frame पासून S prime मध्ये याचा प्रयत्न करते. बस थांबते म्हणजे काय? इट ट्राईज टू बिकम अ इनर्शियल फ्रेम. आणि जेव्हा इनर्शियल फ्रेम मध्ये याचा प्रयत्न करते, तेव्हा तुमच्या अंगावर तो फिक्शियस फोर्स अप्लाय होतो. आणि इट इज अन इमॅजिनरी फोर्स. नो वन इज देअर हु इज बेसिकली पुशिंग यू. असं आहे का कोमल जाधव आहे जी तुझ्या सिंगला पुढे ढकलते बस चालू असताना? असं नाही होत. काय होतं? you are rotation relay is pushing in the forward direction because of acceleration of force. Okay, that is one example. Second example, centrifugal force in a car. When car take a turn on a quick turn on a circular track, passenger experiences outward force. This outward force is a fictitious force acting on a passenger known as a centrifugal force. Okay, so hope all of you got what are the examples and why you observe there is a fictitious force. Okay, now tell me some another example of fictitious force you will observe. You have observed. Do you know any example of this fictitious force? Can anyone tell me some example? One example.
मेरी-गो-राउंड
मेरी गो राउंड. ओके गुड. मेरी गो राउंड मध्ये देखील आपल्याला पाहायला मिळतो. नाउ एक्सप्लेन वेअर इज अ सुडो फोर्स इन मेरी गो राउंड फर्स्ट.
मेरी गो राउंड जो हॉरिझॉन्टल मूव होतो तो आपण टेंजेंशियल डायरेक्शन ने फोर्स एक्सपीरियंस करतो तो
आपल्याला वाटतं की आपण पण बाहेरच्या बाजूला फेकले जात आहोत. बरोबर आहे का? तुम्हाला आणखी एक माहिती आहे का की लोकांना आहे ना बस मध्ये म्हणा किंवा ते जे मोठं पाळणं असतो ना जॉइंट व्हील त्याच्यामध्ये बसल्यानंतर उलट्या होतात. बरोबर आहे का? बऱ्याच जणांचा अनुभव असेल. नाही उलट्या का होतो माहिती आहे का? बस लागते म्हणतो आपण. बरोबर आहे. इट इज ऑल्सो अन इफेक्ट ऑफ द फिक्शियस फोर्स. आवर ह्युमन बॉडी इज ट्राइंग टू बी इन इनर्शियल फ्रेम ऑलवेज. आपली बॉडी जी आहे ना ती इनिशियल फ्रेम मध्ये राहायचा प्रयत्न करत. पण रस्ता जो आहे किंवा त्याचे काही गोल गोल फिरणं आहे मेरी गो राऊंड मध्ये म्हणा किंवा त्या जॉइंट व्हील मध्ये म्हणा किंवा बस मध्ये बसून जाणं. सो ड्युरिंग दॅट मोशन युअर बॉडी इज ऑलवेज चेंजिंग इट्स फ्रेम फ्रॉम एस टू एस प्राइम, एस प्राइम टू एस, एस टू एस प्राइम, एस प्राइम टू एस. अँड बिकॉज ऑफ दॅट युअर ब्लड सिस्टम ऑर युअर बेसिकली दॅट ह्युमन बॉडी सिस्टम not responding always to the that change in the frame. Hence when you feel that vomiting is there, this is due to the one of the impact of the fictitious force. Okay, so we have seen what is a fictitious force. Let us go ahead and try to see third example, that is a man in elevator. Again, this man in elevator can be considered as example of this fictitious force. In the last lecture, Pranav Khandke has also mentioned that the man in elevator can be considered as a effect of fictitious force. So here, if you wanted to determine fictitious force, then that fictitious force is basically observed due to the acceleration of this lift. If you look at the three diagrams, we are having three diagrams: first, second, and third. In the first diagram, when elevator is stopped, this means there is no acceleration to the elevator, so one can say that lift is in a inertial frame and hence only fg is there. And one normal force which is acting on the person who is sitting in the that elevator, so that fg is equals to normal force. Because of that, man cannot be basically change its position, he is always there. Now if that man or that lift is going in the negative direction, that is the acceleration is negative. When acceleration is negative, this means that this elevator is going in the upward direction. Then we can write down what will be the force due to the this change in the or due to the lift going in the upward direction. That can be written as minus of ma. A is negative here and fg is always there. So again, there will be one normal force but the normal force in the upward direction and Fg is in the downward direction. They will balance each other, but this Ma minus will be there, and which will be the one of the reason why you are again feel uncomfortable in a lift. This uncomfortableness is also an effect of the pseudo force. When A is a positive, at that time you are feel like a weightlessness. So it is also example of or effect of fictitious force. When elevator is a stop condition, only gravity is acting on the man, and hence net force acting on the man will be F net is equal to mg. On the other hand, if you look at the negative A, then net force acting on the man will be mg minus ma. When elevator is moving in the upward direction, then the force due to the acceleration in the elevator and the gravity both in the downward direction. Hence, F net is equal to mg plus ma. If applied acceleration is equal to the gravity, then man feels weightlessness. So this is an example of pseudo force. Example 4. Have you seen this machine before? Have you seen this type of machine before?
No.
Okay. So if you are not seen this machine before, then you will see this machine in the chemistry labs. Basically, this machine known as a centrifugal machine, centrifuge machine. So what is there? We are having some cylinders here, and in that cylinder we are going to put our test tubes, and in the test tubes we are having some liquid, and in that liquid we are having some particulate matter, some particles which are basically moving in the that liquid. And if I wanted to separate out that liquid and particles, then I have to use this machine. So what we are doing, we are taking that liquid which contains the particles, and we will keep this test tubes in this machine. We will have four test tubes in this machine, and here is one handle. And with using this handle, what we are doing, we are trying to give a circular rotation or rotational motion to the system. So what will happen? Due to the rotation, liquid molecules will basically, they doesn't have large mass, but the particles which are there inside the liquid, they are having some mass, and that mass experiences that fictitious force. And because of that fictitious force, the particles which are there, these particles are throwing in the upward direction. And because of that, at the bottom of the test tube, you will observe that the particles are settled down, and over that we are having those liquids. So those particles are basically separated out with the help of this centrifuge machine. Due to this force, due to the fictitious force, the tiny particles settle down at the bottom of the test tube. And that force is given as centrifugal force, which is equals to mv square by r. Did you? I think some of you have seen this example before. If you are not seen this machine before, then you are certainly going to use this machine in a chemistry practicals. In the physics practicals also, we are having some practicals on the basis of this. But there, at that time, we are having some advanced machinery, and that machinery is basically used for your project. So at the time of your TYBSC project, you might use a centrifuge machine for your practicals on projects. Okay. In the next lecture, we will discuss some of the real life applications of Newton's laws of motion. Here I have shown some of the examples. Football does not move until someone kick it. Astronomers finds it is difficult to move in the spaceship. If the cloth pulled quickly, then dish stay on the table. So main examples are there. We will discuss these examples in the next lecture. Here is a second law, third law. So these are some examples that we will discuss, and after that we will discuss some of the problems. And add that after this all the things, we are at the end of chapter number 1. So in the today's lecture, we have seen a fictitious force, pseudo force, and we try to examine why fictitious force will be there and what will be the equation for fictitious force that we have seen. We will just take a small recap what we have seen. We have started with the two frame, S frame and S prime frame. S prime frame is accelerating frame with acceleration a zero. Initial velocity, let us consider u, and S frame is stationary frame, and we are going to consider there is one particle which is in a S prime frame, which is moving with some velocity. Take a minute. And this velocity will be different for two different frames. If someone is sitting in S prime, then that velocity will be v. If someone is sitting in S prime frame, then that velocity will be v prime. So the velocity observed by the S frame will be equal, basically equals to the addition of two different velocities. Velocity of that particle plus velocity of that frame with respect to S frame. So that we have written down here. We have write down law of addition of velocities. V prime is equals to V minus U. So where U is the velocity of S prime frame relative to S frame. And if you look at the differential part of this equation, then if you differentiate it, then we'll get dv prime by dt is equals to dv by dt minus du by dt. And here dv prime by dt is a prime, dv by dt is a, and du by dt is a zero. U is the velocity of the S prime frame. So we can determine that du by dt is basically a acceleration of that S prime. A prime is the acceleration of a particle in a S frame. A is the acceleration of a butterfly or of that particle which is observed from S frame. It is observed from S prime frame. It is observed from S frame, and it is this A zero is basically a acceleration of S prime frame with respect to S frame. And then we have multiplied it with mass of that particle, and we have observed that F prime is equals to F minus F zero. And we try to write down F prime as a total force. So the total force is equals to force observed in S frame minus fictitious force. And this is basically a relation which tells us that F prime is equals to F minus F zero. F zero is fictitious force. F is a force observed from S prime, and F prime is a force observed from S prime. Okay, and then we have seen some of the examples. Okay, in the today's lecture, we have seen this fictitious force, pseudo force. Do you have any doubt regarding today's lecture? Do you have any doubt regarding today's lecture?
No, sir.
No, sir.
So I think we should stop here. We will discuss remaining few real life applications of Newton's laws of motion and a few problems in the next lecture. Thank you for your
sir.
Ha, bola.
Sir, centrifugal force, pseudo force, has spoken.
Yes, centrifugal force is pseudo force.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Centripetal जो आए, तो real force असतो. सेंट्रीफ्युगल जो आहे तो सुडो फोर्स. सेंट्रीपिटल मध्ये पहा, आपण त्याला फिरवतो, आपल्या हातामध्ये दोरी असते आणि आपण त्याला फिरवायचा प्रयत्न करतो. सो इट इज बेसिकली सेंट्रीपिटल फोर्स. आणि सेंट्रीफ्युगल मध्ये तो जो पार्टिकल त्या टेस्ट ट्यूब मध्ये असेल तो बाहेर फेकला जातो, त्याला कोणी फेकत नाही बाहेर, तो फेकला जातो. दिस इज ड्यू टू दॅट रोटेशन ऑर द ऍक्सलरेशन ऑफ दॅट सर्क्युलर मोशन. ओके, एनीवन एल्स हू हॅव एन डाऊट? So we'll stop here.